Oh, we pray to. Hey. I've been practicing still. I'm trying to get ready for my audition. I mean, I love singing, don't you? Are you guys ready for worship? Are you guys gonna sing with me too? No, but really. Hey, get on your feet. Let's worship together, kids. Come on.
Good morning, C3 kids. Are you ready to worship the God who made you and loves you? We're gonna lift him up this morning. Let's join together. We'll praise the weapon that silences the enemy. Let praise be a weapon that conquers all anxiety. Let it rise. Let praise arise. We sing your name in the dark and it changes everything. We sing with all we are and we claim your victory. Cannot survive when we praise you. The God of breakthroughs on your side, forever lift you high. With all creation, God, oh, we praise you. Oh, we praise you. Oh, let's go. Let faith be the song that overcomes the rage. Let faith be the song that calms the storm inside of me. Let it rise. Let faith arise. Yeah! We'll see you break down every wall. We'll watch the giants fall. For fear cannot survive when we praise you. The God of breakthroughs on our side. Forever lift you high with all creation, God. Oh, we praise you. Oh, we praise you. Oh, break it down here. This is what living looks like. This is what freedom feels like. This is what heaven sounds like. We praise you, we praise you. This is what living looks like. This is what freedom feels like. This is what heaven sounds like. We praise you, we praise you. This is what living looks like. This is what freedom feels like. This is what heaven sounds like. We praise you. We'll see you break down every wall. We'll watch the giants fall. 'Cause fear cannot survive when we praise you. The God of breakthroughs on your side. Forever lift you high. With all creation, God, oh, we praise you.
Kids, my name is Agent Lizbeth.
And I'm Agent Seth. Excuse us, we just finished watching our all-time favorite spy movie called Spy Kids.
We love spy movies. Spy Kids is about the Cortezes, who are a family of spies, except that the children, Carmen and Junie, don't know that they have spy blood in them yet. Their parents are retired spies who choose to keep it a secret from them to protect them. Yet, Carmen and Junie found out that hard way when they have to go on their first mission to save their parents who were stolen by the evil villain, Minion.
That's right. The notorious Minion was actually building an army of androids that looked just like the children. He called them spy kids. These kids looked just like Junie and Carmen, except they didn't have brains and couldn't talk. He wanted to steal their identity and use it to take over the world.
You know what that got me thinking of? Minion knew the power these agents had, and he made it his mission to get rid of all the spies by stealing their identity and taking their power. And that's pretty similar to what the enemy does. The enemy is a liar. Once we know who we are, that is, children of God, forgiven and loved, his goal is to steal our identity away from us. He wants us to forget who we really are in our new creation.
That's right. Ephesians 1:4 says, even before he made the world, God loved us and chose us in Christ to be holy and without fault in his eyes. If we only know we are in Christ and we are his kids and heirs, we can be unstoppable. We could be like super spies for God. Yeah!
That's right. But it's really easy to forget that we are God's kids, and we forget who we are. James 1:22 through 25 says, when we forget who we are, it's like someone who looks at themselves in the mirror and then walks away and forgets what they look like. This is when sin comes in. Have you ever done something bad or slimy, like make fun of someone or disobey a parent or teacher, and you look back on what you did and say, that's not who I am. That looks like a mean and selfish person, but I am a kind and selfless person. I know that's who God made me to be. Those two things don't match up. You just forget your identity for a moment.
In the movie, the son is getting picked on a lot at school, and there's a scene where the dad is dropping the kids off at school, and he calls out to the son from the car to remind him that when he gets picked on, remember that he is a Cortez. The son replies, what's so special about being a Cortez? And his father responds, everything. And this is how God sees us. God looks at us as a new creation. He sees us as holy and blameless, forgiven and loved because we are in Christ. He doesn't see all of our mess ups. He sees us as we were created to be, our true identity. Remember at Easter how we talked about Jesus going to the cross to die for our sins? Well, his sacrifice allows us to get rid of our old sinful selves and take up our new identity. Romans 6 says our old way of life was nailed to the cross with Christ, mm-hmm. a decisive end to that sin-miserable life, no longer captive to sin's demands.
Yeah, that means that the old part of you, all the messy and slimy parts, died on the cross and stayed in the grave. It's gone. Only the new creation that was born again exists now. Romans 7:6 says, we get to live in a new way in the Spirit and are free from our old ways. The word old here in Greek actually means irrelevant, worn out, useless, out of date. The old you is all of those things. It has no power over you. God doesn't need us to do everything perfectly and follow the rules. He wants us to live a life that is in line with who we really are.
So you too can be a super spy for Jesus yeah. and have super cool action moves like this. No? It looked cooler when I was practicing in the bathroom.
How about you show us some cool prayer moves instead?
Good idea. Dear God, thank you so much for dying on the cross for us so that our old sinful selves can die too and that we can have new life inside of us and a new identity that is as children of God. We love you, God. In your name we pray, amen.
Amen. So I'm gonna throw it to Butterfly Katie, who is raising our caterpillars into butterflies.
Hi, C3 kids, it's Katie, and guess who I have here? Our butterfly friends. So we have 4 butterflies total right now, and we're waiting on our baby Luna to come out of her cocoon and join us and her butterfly friends. So God always knew these butterflies were gonna be wonderful butterflies. Even when they were caterpillars in that tiny little cup full of dirt at the very beginning, he saw them as wonderful butterflies. He gave these butterflies their identity and they listened when he told them who they were. They responded to the truth God saw in them, and now they're getting ready to be set free. So just like butterflies, God knows who we are before we even know who we are. This is just so cool. I wish I could keep these butterflies forever, but you know, they belong outside in nature, so that's where they're gonna be. We're just waiting on little Luna so we could encourage her to come out of her cocoon. That would be awesome. Come on, come on, come on, come on, Luna. All right, kids, that's it for this week. Tune in next week where I will be setting these butterflies free into the world. Okay, bye.